Well, I'm going to give the information I have. Like I told you this afternoon when we talked, I'm going to give you the information that Steve got that dovetailed with it. And then I'm going to have you give some information that perhaps is the tripod or the third leg of the tripod of this dire subject matter. So I'll just start out, then I'll have you chime in, and we'll tie in with what you know and what you found out in the last few days, that independently of what Steve did or I did, all of us, totally different sources, but it all fits together, doesn't it?
Yes, sir, it does.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, what I have is from deep background sources, I would just say, in the intelligence community of the United States. And I would say that they are good guys, probably, as good guys can be. And, ladies and gentlemen, it's basically extremely dire, and that's why I use the word urgency and how this may have been last night a herald or a portent of what something evil coming. And basically, the story of the situation is that during this recent summit, this nuclear non-proliferation summit in which Barry Sotero, the Lucy Joker Tut, met under the symbol of the crescent moon and star on all the logos and in the center of the caricature or fake or anti-Knights of the Round Table sort of meeting of all the 47 countries, and 4 and 7 is 11, ladies and gentlemen. 11, like 9-11? I don't know. But as you recall, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm just going to give you a little background here, the Obama speeches, he talked about that he was, and the Washington Times says, critics say Obama is hyping terrorist nuclear risk. And in his talks about it, he kept going on and on and on about a nuclear threat to the United States with terrorist nukes, and that was the bigger threat than any state nukes or China or Iran or Russia or anybody firing, you know, long-range nuclear weapons, that it was the terror threat that was the key. And here's the situation there, is that he mentioned, and if you remember the UK or United Kingdom or the London Telegraph art section story on blackjack, in which a group of evil men used terrorist attacks with nuclear weapons on London, New York, other cities in the United States, Canada, and Mexico in order to do a total martial law and total military takeover of the, what they called was the Union of North America, the UNA. And you remember the cartoon-like thing, it was about 4 or 5 parts. If you don't remember it, look for the blackjack scenario. It's probably up on YouTube as well if it's no longer at the London Times or UK Times online in the art section. Blackjack is the scenario. It's like a 4 or 5 part series. But in that, we got out of these nuclear attacks, martial law in the United States, totally military takeover, you know, camps, death camps, prison camps, you know, concentration camp things, total destruction of the economy, all of the whole 9 yards of a sacrifice to Lucifer, blood sacrifice, meat grinder system. Well, anyway, ladies and gentlemen, at this conference, apparently, because Sotero, Lucy Joker Tut, knows that the economy is going to collapse, that the banking system is going to collapse, and they really don't care because they're the ones that have been doing it. And with the bankers, Illuminati, Lucy bankers, looting $28 trillion and keep spending and spending and spending and telling you, you've got to now pay all these new taxes, which will totally further destroy the economy if they're put on. Well, knowing that, and then knowing also that the Red Chinese are some of the largest holders of U.S. debt, in the discussions, after a nice polite bow with Hu Jintao, the deep background sources say that a deal was cut between Mr. Lucy Joker Tut and Mr. H.J. Red Chinese that basically would allow China to do some sort of nuclear attack on the United States as a false flag terror attack. And listen to this, ladies and gentlemen, and to blame it on Israel. Bingo, do things start to make sense about the crescent moon and maybe why Bibi Netanyahu didn't want to come to this one? Does it make sense how Obama says, Obama's speech, New York Times, signals a shift on the Middle East, and where they're no longer going to favor Israel, so to speak, and all the snubs and bubs and all of the terrible relations and the finger-pointing, all of that. And so here you have this scenario which could then start the Gog-Magog Middle East war as well and cause world leaders and governments all over the Middle East and all over Europe and other places in the U.S. and the populations to then hate Israel, the beloved of the Lord. Think about the ramifications of that. Anyway, as I hurriedly got this information, trying to get it to Steve Quayle. I kept trying to get him on the phone. I finally got him late last evening. And I told him this scenario that I just said that basically was sourced. And incidentally, the good guys in the intelligence and military high Leo world are extremely mad about this and about the treason that apparently is exhibited if such a deal is, in fact, so. And they believe it to be so, the sources do, that there is a righteous anger. And I just want to say to all the good guys out there in the intel military world, do something, stand while you can for the Lord and for the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, and do try to do something, anything you possibly can do, no matter how minute, to stop this. So then I told all of this to Steve, and Steve said, Hawk, you ain't going to believe it. Hawk, he says, I've been talking to a China Joe, and there are more than one, ladies and gentlemen. So this particular China Joe told him that he expected on an imminent basis, and these dates to me don't mean anything because the U.S. sources, deep background, had no dates, although they thought it would be this year. But no immediate date or hard date or any kind of speculative date. But the China Joe guy said that from now and even possibly now early, you know, as to possibly by the 4th of May of this year, that he expected that something would occur that would cause the banking systems to collapse in the United States, and that because of that, most of the high-level people in China were going to their country bug-out locations, which are fully stocked, just like the wealthiest people here would have, that type of thing, underground, you know, houses, that kind of stuff, shelters, food, water, you know, NBC type equipment, firearms, the whole nine yards. That they were going, and that all their accounts that he had taken, was taking all of his accounts, and that would be substantial, let's just say millions, ladies and gentlemen, that he was putting them into a special, now get this, escrow fund created by the New World Order Illuminati bankers that is a parallel and separate system from the current banking, financial, and currency systems of the world. It's a new one they've set up. So their funds are preserved, and they document them, whereas your funds will be all gone unless you take steps to correct it. Furthermore, he then still said that even those funds in the escrow accounts would probably be taken because there would be a need in the total collapse of the world, and this is a worldwide economic collapse, and starting in the U.S. and other places. That there was a need, they would take those funds as well. So he wasn't sure about his funds being safe. But be that as it may, he also then said that he heard from the highest levels in China that there was some kind of deal struck or cut with the Lucy Joker cut that would allow China to do an EMP attack on the United States, or a cyber attack, massive cyber attack on the United States that would take down the financial system and probably the power grids, etc. An EMP would certainly do that. And get this, no country specified, and then also to blame it as a false flag on some unidentified third country or nation or group. So those two sources are totally independent, separate times of the day. Steve and I put those together and we said, oh boy, I then talked to Mr. Greg Evenson today, who I've been trying to catch on the road. And Greg, why don't you come in now and dovetail right in with your information, brother?
Thanks, Hawk. What we're seeing, I believe, is the final vice grip being exercised across this great nation. We're being assailed both from the geopolitical and, of course, economic, but it goes much further than that, even down to the lowest levels, if you will, and by lowest I mean the local levels of law enforcement, just in the last 24 to